If you're a coach, a consultant, or a contractor that has to close customers using a sales call, then you're probably going to want to check out this video where I share how you can automate this entire process using one of the simplest to set up and cheapest to run automated sales funnels. My name is Amber Renee, and I'm an online business strategist, personal brand expert, and chief funnel builder at amber.courses, where I have a heap of free hour-long training masterclasses for you to check out. Everything that we cover on this channel, plus heaps more, like influencer marketing, personal branding, how to build e-courses, and mastering your mindset. So check them out below. Now, I've personally built hundreds of different sales funnels in my day, and I freaking love automation, and I love sharing these strategies with you. So let's dive in and find out how you can simplify some of your sales process. So first up, what the f*** is a funnel? So a funnel is just a fancy way of talking about a customer journey. So it's the journey that you take your customers on from awareness through consideration to purchase. It's where you take your cold audience, or people who are completely unaware of you, through a nurture sequence, giving them lots of valuable information, building that know, like, and trust factor, and inevitably leading to a sale. Because once your funnel is set up, it does all of the nurture sequence for you, and then you just have to focus on putting out really high quality content that converts and then closing people on a sales call. So have you ever struggled not knowing what to post on social media? Because having a clearly defined content strategy will help you overcome that and help you become a more clever and strategic marketer. So I want you to ask yourself, what piece of content naturally forms the bridge between someone being completely unaware of you to someone developing enough trust with you to want to enter your funnel and eventually pick up a phone call and have a sales call with you? So ask yourself, what should I post on social media to get people to enter the top of my funnel? So what I found that works really well here is short, kind of about 5 minute videos, even less than 5 minutes, works really well as it quickly builds rapport and expresses domain authority and educates your people. So you want to test out various content types and see what really works for your audience. So what video topics convert best? What does your audience search for on Google? What common questions do you get asked again and again about your area of expertise? Even go and search through your competitors' social media channels and find out what questions they're getting asked over and over again, and then just answer those questions. Now, if you're struggling to know what video content to create, a super simple video idea is where you give your potential buyers a behind the scenes view of what it's like to work with you. So for instance, if you're selling a coaching package or anything where you will be on a live call actively coaching someone, why not record that call, privacy permitting, and edit it down to be a quick Q&A style quickfire video. So we did this recently for one of the coaching calls that you get inside of my signature e-course, Freedom Funnels. Freedom Funnels teaches you how to launch a profitable e-course. So now I have a whole masterclass on how to do that. If you want to check it out below, it's free. You can watch it below. But on one of those weekly coaching calls, we edited that call down and we included timestamps where each question was answered. Now, the questions were the same sort of questions that anyone that's wanting to create an e-course or a funnel would want to know. So, and the beauty of it was I was in this like high energy environment. So I was firing off these questions and it came really easily to me and it was delivered really well. So we edited the video down into the short Q&A questions that most course creators want to know. And then we put that out onto social media. Now, the beauty of this type of video is that it's twofold. So firstly, it takes your potential buyer inside. So they truly get to experience what it's like working with you one-on-one. And secondly, it develops expert status really efficiently as your potential buyer can see you firing off questions really quickly and easily, which establishes trust and establishes expert status. And the best part is that this is content you've already got. So just get it edited down and you're all set to go. So if you're doing any sort of consulting or freelancing, figure out what you can record that takes people inside the journey of what it's actually like to work with you, and then put that out onto your socials as your top of funnel piece of content. That way people really get an understanding of what it would be like if they were to hire you. Now, if you're loving this, make sure you hit the subscribe button and leave me a comment what piece of content you've already got created that you can start using as your top of funnel content to get people to enter your funnel and sign up to a sales call. Now, once you've created your super high value video, now it's time to create a super simple landing page using your favorite landing page builder like Lead Pages or ClickFunnels, or you could just use a conversion focused theme on your WordPress website like Thrive Themes. And even these days at the time of recording, MailChimp have a basic one page opt-in landing page. Now remember, the whole purpose of this page is to keep the page super clean. So no external links to other content such as blogs or any other videos. The only way off this page is to either schedule a call with you or to click off at the top button. So you then want to start spreading the word about this awesome piece of content that you've just created. So think about repurposing that video into multiple posts so that you can post about it repeatedly without exhausting your audience and feeling like you're just posting the same video over and over again. So at a minimum, you could cut down, let's say you have a 5-minute video, you could cut that down into at least 6 posts. So post 1 is the video, post 2, 3, and 4, edit out little grabs. So like a 30-second grab or a 2-minute grab or a 60-second grab. That's 3 more posts. Then find a couple of awesome one-liners and deliver them as quote cards. So put the actual one-liner onto a quote card. So that's another couple of posts. And then you could publish the post as a long form transcript and just grab a thumbnail or, you know, any kind of image and use that as a long form post. So just from that one piece of video content, you've got 6 posts that you can repeatedly push out there and get people aware of your content and get them opting in to jump on a call and enter a nurture sequence with you. So you can see there are so many possibilities here, and all social posts should always lead back to your content landing page with the full length video at the top of the page, the 5-minute video right at the top. Now you could also think about including a self-liquidating offer just to give you some extra cash that you can spend on serving ads to your cold audience. So this could be a small offering such as an ebook or a mini video series that you sell for, say, $7. So this happens after someone opts in. So rather than taking them to a thank you page, you would take them to a one-time only offer page. Now I have a whole video on creating digital downloads, so make sure you check that out next. Now there will be a small percentage of people watching your highly valuable training that will want to take an immediate next step with you. So give them that opportunity. Present them with a one-time only offer and see if you convert 10 to 20% of your opt-ins. Now the one-time only offer should be a product that is the next logical step in the customer journey. So ask yourself, what do my customers need right now to continue down the purchase path with me? And then, well, you give that to them as soon as they opt in to schedule a call with you. Now think about including a quick 3-minute sales video with more information about your signature offering or what you're going to be talking about on the sales call. You could always include this at the end of your content video that's on the top of the page, but as I'm sure you already know, the large majority of people will not watch all the way to the end of a video. So instead, on that one landing page, you can include a separate video at the bottom of that page that helps people understand what your sales concept is. So your sales video should help leads identify that you would be the solution to their problem and to also break any objections that they may have in scheduling a call with you. And you really want to pre-qualify your leads with a link to a SurveyMonkey or an online form that requires some level of commitment and to potentially identify whether that person can afford or is interested in your package. This will also help weed out the people who are not really that serious. After all, you don't want to schedule up your calendar with a whole bunch of calls that never show up. Now, once someone completes a pre-qualifying survey and you have a call booked in, think about what content you can send them before the call in order to build that know, like, and trust factor. So things like testimonials, case studies, or W11FM videos work here. W11FM stands for What's In It For Me. It's everyone's favorite radio station. Now you want to secure the bag. So if you ask the right questions, you will get a pretty good understanding of what problem your client is looking to solve. So how urgently are they looking to get their problem solved, and what lengths are they willing to go to solve that problem? Be discerning and remember, there is no one size fits all offer. Consider the buying cycle and that only about 10% of all calls are ready to buy your first offer and are ready to buy now. So instead, think about alternate package options, both upsells and downsells to your original offer that you can sell to everyone that you speak to. And think about different package and pricing structures that will get the non-buyers across the line. Content funnels to sales calls are an efficient way to reach new audience, connect more closely with your existing audience, and to establish you as top of mind. They're easy to build, cheap to run, and tend to convert really well due to the intimate nature of having a one-on-one call with someone. So make sure you test them out in your business. And if you're looking for my 5-step process for launching an online business, then make sure you watch this video next. And if you got value out of this, then please hit that like button, please subscribe, and leave me a comment, as it just lets others know that this is a valuable way to spend a couple of minutes of their day. So go ahead and spread the love. My name's Amber Renee. I help you with your brand, your business, and your mindset, and I'll see you in next week's video.